In the previous lecture, we studied all this ray tracing in convex, concave mirror, convex mirror. We also studied the different cases of image formation for different positions of the object in a concave mirror, and we also studied the different cases, the sixth case. Now we are going to study the image formation in case of a convex mirror. Here there is only one case for all different positions of the object. Means the object can be here, the object can be here, the object can be here, the object can be here. The image will be virtual, cannot be caught on a screen, small in size, diminished, erect, and between pole P and focus F of the mirror. Here is the object AB, A dash B dash is the image. I will explain it, and you will find if this object moves away from the mirror, this image A dash B dash will shift towards PF, and when this will be at infinity, the image will be a point image at F. Means as the object moves away from the mirror, the image will move towards the focus F and gradually diminish in size. Now look, M dash is the convex mirror, P is the pole of the mirror, this line is the principal axis, this is the focus, this is the center of curvature. From P to F is called focal length, from P to C is called radius of curvature, and in the previous chapter we have derived 2 times F is equal to R, 2 times this distance is equal to the radius of curvature. Now here is an object AB. To find the image of A, I take a ray parallel to the principal axis, so it will be reflected from here. I have not drawn the normal because with so many lines the figure will get crowded, and we know a ray coming parallel to the principal axis in case of a convex mirror, it appears to come from focus. This is reflected like this. If you produce it backward, it appears to come from focus. Now the second ray, two rays are required to find the image. The second ray, a ray traveling in the direction of C. From this point, it is reflected, because at this point, this will be the normal. This is the incident ray. Angle of incidence is zero. So according to laws of reflection, if angle of incidence is zero, angle of reflection has to be zero, so it is reflected in the same direction. So this also appears to come from behind. Now from here I have taken two rays, one and the second. The first after reflection from here and the second after reflection from here appear to come from a common point A dash. So A dash is the image of A. Therefore I draw a straight line. So B dash is the image of P. So A dash B dash is the virtual image of AB, because here if you put a screen, this won't be there. This won't be caught on the screen, and it is between P and F. Now let us see what happens if I shift this object away from the mirror. If it is not here, is here, if the object AB is here, then this ray will remain same. Now from this point, the second ray which goes in the direction of C, will be reflected from here, in the same direction. So this appears to come from behind. Now the point of intersection of this and this, this ray and this ray after reflection is not here, is here. So this is the image now. So this is also between P and F. So the conclusion is, as the object moves away from the mirror, the image shifts towards the focus, gradually decreases in size and still virtual. In forthcoming lectures, we shall find image formation in concave mirror, which was 6 different cases, is identical to image formation in convex lens. Convex lens will be like this. Here the image formation will be similar to the case of image formation in concave mirror. And image formation in convex mirror, the one I just discussed here, will be identical to image formation in concave lens, which will be like this. We'll study these two separately in different lectures.